And a good Wednesday to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for checking out the tropics with me. My name is Jewel, and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. Okay, folks, I'm not going to have a lot of fancy graphs, this, that, and all the other. I'm going to get right down to the point. We have Tropical Storm Lee. Well, you know what? Lee is approaching hurricane strength right now. And it's going to rapidly intensify into an extremely dangerous hurricane by this weekend. What's going on right now? We will check out disturbance number one. It's a tropical wave. It is producing a large area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms over the far eastern Atlantic between the Cabo Verde Islands and the west coast of Africa. All of the environmental conditions appear conducive for some gradual development of the system, and a tropical depression could form later this week or this weekend while it's moving west-northwestward at around 10 to 15 miles per hour. This system is expected to move across the Cabo Verde Islands tonight and tomorrow Thursday, and everybody who lives on the islands in the Cabo Verde Islands, please keep up. Now, in 2 days, 30% chance. 7 days, 60% chance. And then we have disturbance number two, X Franklin, the leftovers, post-tropical cyclone Franklin. It's a few hundred miles east-northeast of the Azores. It is producing disorganized shower activity, mostly to the east of its center. Now, this system could briefly acquire some subtropical or tropical characteristics during the next day or two while it moves northeastward or northward over the northeastern Atlantic. And by late this week, further development is not expected as this system is going to move into unfavorable environmental conditions. And that should cause it to weaken. Okay? Now, it's looking like 2 days, it's very low, 10%. 7 days, still very low, 10%. As of right now, this is probably going to change at the 8 o'clock or 11 o'clock update. All these things update at different times. But right now, the winds are 65 miles per hour in Lee. And the barometric pressure is beginning to fall. It's 997 millibars. Located 13.7 north, 44.6 west, and it's moving around 14 miles per hour west northwest. Now, this is slower than it has been moving. That's a sign it's really going to ramp up, okay? Really going to start to ramp up. Probably when it gets over in this area over in here, It will be a hurricane more than likely. If not, pretty darn close. Now, here we have the tracking map. All of this is from the National Hurricane Center. Everything in here is more or less where it's going to go, where you see the dark gray under it. It's going to become a major hurricane. It's going to explode, folks. I'm just telling you. Now, this is something you really have to pay attention to. The cone of uncertainty. It can go anywhere. It could come this way. It could get further down this way. You see what I'm saying? It can go here. It can go here. It can bounce around anywhere in this area. Anywhere. It can go. Now, it's kind of frightful, I must admit. As a matter of fact, I've been trying to get me a motel room. There's no way if this storm gets close to me that I can stay here. But guess what? I live in a tourist trap area and there are none at this time. But I'm still trying and don't worry about me, okay? Just say prayers. But there's two ways this thing can go. Yes, we have a small trough, but we've got a great big high over here. We got another high that's going to be forming up in here, okay? This trough could pull it out. The jet stream is still a little ways out to really know where it's going. But here's what it's looking like to me right now. It is either going to come up this way and go out this way, or it's either going to come up this way and get closer to the outer banks. You don't have to take my word for it. Look, my local weather people are even talking about it, and they never do anything this early. And I wanted a little more. So this is what one of my friends that is a national meteorologist had to say.
This hurricane is going to explode Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. In fact, even in the early next week, historically, these systems that go north of Hispaniola really intensify. I would not be surprised at some point early next week if we go to a Category 5 hurricane. That's up above 156 mile per hour winds. That's the concern here. Now, where does it go from here? We still see two scenarios. There's a strong enough trough along the East Coast that would steer this system out to sea lee, and it would be a powerful hurricane. It would be weakening a little bit. That's scenario number one. Scenario number two is that the trough is farther west, and that will allow Lee to come closer to the United States. This is certainly a possibility. So here's what you need to know. This is going to be a powerful hurricane in the southwest Atlantic early next week. It could approach Category 5 status. Category 5 is up above 156 mile per hour winds. I think it's going to come close enough right now that you really have to pay attention to this. From the Outer Banks of North Carolina all the way to northern Nova Scotia, and that does mean the northeast coast late next week. Regardless, because it's such a powerful hurricane, there's going to be dangerous rip currents up and down the eastern seaboard.
Okay, all of my island people. Now, none of this is wrote in stone, folks. Okay, we all know there's going to be changes probably. You got to keep up. Now, this is showing you when you could feel some wind. Looking like right in here, starting early Friday morning, around 8 a.m., Friday evening up in this area as it moves off. It still should be offshore, but I think it's going to be a hurricane. Now, your winds at this point, I really can't tell about. I don't think they will be over 60 mile per hour wind gust right now, especially as you get up in the northern section of the island chain here. And if this moves on, Puerto Rico, you may feel some around Saturday at 8 p.m., shouldn't be quite as much as down right in the northern island chain, as you can see. Once again, I'm not saying this is wrote in stone. It could be more, it could be less. I'm thinking around 60 mile per hour wind gust. Maybe a little higher, maybe a little lower. And it's looking like you might get a little bit of rain. I don't think you're going to get that much. I've done some research on the storm. Yes, it has rained, but this is more of a windmaker than a rainmaker. Very, very dangerous. And the waves, I've seen storm surge. Once it gets up past the islands and starts to move on up, and I've seen waves now, 38-foot waves. So everybody in the island areas down in here, you make sure you've got what you need and you're prepared, because this thing is going to ramp up, and more than likely it's going to be a hurricane when it passes by. It should stay out to sea. No one should have a direct hit right now, but we still have that cone of uncertainty. So please be prepared in every way as this thing comes rolling through. Please keep check on my community page. I will put updates up there as they come in, okay? Please keep abreast of the community page. Key messages right now. Lee is forecast to become a major hurricane by late this week and could bring impacts to the Leeward Islands this weekend. While it is too soon to determine the location and magnitude of these possible impacts, interest in these areas should monitor the progress of Lee for further updates. You can see the intensity right now, 65 mile per hour winds. In 12 hours, it will be a Category 1 hurricane. 24 hours, then it's just going to bump right on up to a Category 5, 120 hours from now. I will be having more videos throughout the day. Just keep checking back. I will have them periodically as more information comes in, but I would like to make just one suggestion. I don't ever tell you guys what to do when you write me a comment saying, it looks like it's coming, what should I do? I never tell you what to do. I just tell you what it's looking like. You have to make your own minds up. But as for North Carolina, coastlines of Virginia up to the Delmarva Peninsula, and maybe New Jersey and Long Island moving right on up, please keep up with this storm. Don't wait until you think it is actually going to hit you. If it does, now once again, it could go out a little bit. That would be wonderful. But it could ride right up the coastline also. Lots of things are going to depend on it. So I'm trying to make this short and trying to let you know, keep up and stay aware. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what might be coming their way. I appreciate that more than you know. It helps me out a lot to get the word out. Hopefully, maybe this thing will die down. We'll have to wait and see. But I'm telling everyone, watch this every day. As many forecasts as you can get on it. Pay attention to your local weather forecast as well as the national forecast. I love you guys. Thank you for everything you do for me. Donations through PayPal. I've noticed some of you click show more underneath this video. If you scroll down, you'll get a link that you can donate in PayPal if you wish to do so. And I kindly appreciate that and thank you very, very much. Or you can hit the little three buttons underneath this video and you'll see a little thanks heart button. You can click that and I will get a donation through YouTube, whatever you want to send. Take care, my friends. I love you very, very, very much. And everybody, please keep up and pray this thing goes out to sea. Thanks for watching.